One of the great advantages of the XJTAG system is its ease of use, and you can enhance that further by giving XJ Developer a schematic. The XJTAG software can then use it to display information. For example, during project development, XJ Developer can then simplify the categorization process for you by highlighting devices or power nets on the circuit diagram. And XJ Runner can use it during board testing to show you what areas are affected by board faults. So a schematic is really useful. Let me show you how to import one. It needs to be a searchable PDF file, and the process starts in the Add Board dialog box that we looked at last time. It's simply a matter of clicking the Add Schematic button and then navigating to the file. If your schematic is made up of several individual files, highlight them all by holding down the Control key while you select them, or you can add them individually, as I'll show you in a moment. Once you've clicked Open, they'll all be listed in this dialog box. If it's a multi-file schematic, check their order and, if necessary, adjust it using the up and down arrows, because that's the order in which the separate sheets will get displayed when you use them later. If you need to add another schematic file, just click Add. This View button will allow you to check the schematic contents as you go along by opening the viewer. Once they're all there and in the correct order, click OK to add them to your project. If your schematic contains metadata from which BOM details can be extracted, XJ Developer will offer to do so. However, if you've got a separate BOM file, it's usually best to click No at this stage, because a standalone file normally gives a better reflection of what was actually built. You can always extract data from the schematic later if you find it has information you can't get from another source. And that's it. XJ Developer has imported your schematic, which it can now use to highlight specific devices or nets, like here, where we're performing categorization and want to check which device we're looking at. So that's how to import a schematic. But you've probably noticed that several times already in this series, I've commented that you might have a separate BOM file. The next step, a very important one, is to get that BOM into XJ Developer in a way that allows the software to make best use of the information it contains. How to import one is the subject of the next video. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please subscribe for more and leave a like or a comment below.